I'm David Green. I'm the crew chief for water distribution. I run the leaks crew, and we go out, fix water leaks, service leaks. Right now, I'm training a couple of youngsters to be operators on the backhoe. Well, when it's warm outside, we really have leaks every once in a while, but when it's cold, that's when they pop off a lot. And we're out there in the cold, we're getting wet, and I try to keep them, you know, I try to show them how to stay in the hole until the job is done so they're not in and out of the cold and getting sick. I try to stand there until the job is done, because when you're down there, the water's warm. It's when you get out and the air hits you. So I just want to, I try to show my guys to stand there until it's done. Don't get in and out, because that just keeps you cold. But it's times where we can't get it shut off, and it's kind of intense, and your adrenaline is going. That water's spraying on you, especially when it's cold. That water's hitting you. It's kind of intense. Know that I have to get the job done. I know that I have to get that water stopped because, you know, we already a water shortage and all that. So I know that I have to get it done, so I have to stay focused. Sometimes we have valves that are old. Sometimes we have situations where it's not just the water don't just turn off and on like a faucet. We have a lot of valves we have to turn, isolating it so one side of town can still have water. And you know, while you shut down one side of town, you gotta keep hospitals and nursing homes, you gotta keep them in water too. So you gotta look at all that while you're out there too. So it's a little bit of pressure. Sometimes you get out there and you just run into stuff that you've never seen, and it happens, and I just improvise and do what I have to do. I mean, you know, you're gonna have your stress, your times where you're stressed or whatever, but I try to make it fun to keep my crew going, keep everybody going. While we're standing there, it might be one or two people in the hole. That person might be getting ready to get tools for that person. We have pumps going, and at the time, sometimes we're standing there, the backhoe's digging. We can't be down there while the backhoe's digging, so we're waiting to get it exposed, and a lot of people don't understand that. Like when I'm in some neighborhoods and people think they're gonna be without water all night, and I tell them, hey, I ain't leaving until y'all have water or whatever. And then when I do restore the water, they come out and thank us. And I just love what I do. I just love helping people.